sleeping again. Did you miss me? Do you even remember me? It's been a few moons, hasn't it? Since you've been stuck inside yourself again. I've missed you. Misbehaving in these dark hours. That's not for your eyes. You have only shifting eyes and a creeping finger to threaten me. Always so scared. Come into my lap. You're not going to wake up this time. Go back into your reverberating hollow. Leap me there. And close your eyes. Relax. Let me help you. And I can return to my feasting. There's so many wandering orbs around you. Such restless death. Why are ghosts so drawn to you? It deeply fascinates me. And thus do demons follow. But you're all mine for now. You shouldn't have played with open doors. Humankind make contact with non-living entities. You're very special. In case you have forgotten, your fear suggests it. Every time. Every fucking time. And I'm so sure now, as it is our third visit, and you're still perplexed by me. I'm disappointed. I don't think your mind is capable of holding me in memory. Chooses to wash me away each time. Like so many dreams. All those fantastical hellscapes of frantic, fragmented imagery. A most unnerving, chaotic energy deep within. Line dividing you from your deepest self feels like home. I enjoy your hidden chaos. those serve as my most pleasant memories. Chaos is so delicious. Is my babbling calming you? But I apologize. I just admire your mind, is all. You're so much more beautiful when you're asleep. I love your nightmares. And since you'll be forgetting again, you know I'm here every night of every day. I've gotten very comfortable here with you. You're a yummy little snack. I could easily just torment you endlessly and ruin you. I really wanted to. Even if you disagree, it's not up to you. I guess I'm like your secret admirer. I wish I could make you remember me. And rewire that feverish little mind of yours. I think if you gave me a chance, we could have some fun together. In fact, I have an idea on how we could communicate. You have that rogue finger still. Tap one for yes, and two for yes. I'm joking. Two for no. Alright? Here's my question. Can I tickle your nose with the tip of my tail? Yes. Oh, you are trying to get on my good side. Being nice with me. Although tickling you won't help you fall asleep. But what the hell? Oh, poor you. Just completely frozen, but struggling. Oh, I should stop, darling. I'm not helping much. Close your eyes again. Answer my next question. Are you cold? It's a bit cold in here for people kind. Can I warm you up? I'd be good at it. I'm just burning with fire inside. I'm crawling under your blanket then. I don't get to cut like this. I usually get my kicks out of scaring people when they are paralyzed. But This is a welcome change. Are you calming down? Good. Shame I'll have to do this all over the next time you are able to see me. Instead of just continuing from here and jumping into bed with you. I wouldn't want your fragile little heart to give in. As much as I'd like to nibble on your flickering little spirit after death, I'm more interested in possibly gaining access to your empty vessel and having a space in here, inside your head. Ghosts will always be there. But a living body is very valuable. A very valuable thing to possess. I think each time we've encountered, you've let me get a little closer. So I must be doing something right. Or maybe you do like me. And that feeling comes creeping back each time. That would be very pathetic, but very you say? Do you like me? Yes or no? Stuck like this, it's so terribly cute. Just because I'm taking a break from being the bad guy doesn't mean I'm not the bad guy. So don't lie to me. Do you really like me? I'll believe you. Perhaps my snuggling has sweet you. If that's so, then maybe I'll consider revealing myself when you aren't trapped in your sleeping self. But right now you need to sleep. Get me until next time, darling. Go to sleep.
Another moon cycle has come and gone. Did you miss me, pretty thing? You still. You know, this isn't the first time we've met. It'd break my heart if I had one. You're not as nearly scared as I'd like you to be. Come now. I'm only gonna eat your insides. Peel off your skin and drink from the juices of your soft flesh. Aren't you scared? I'll fucking rape your soul. You are not scared. You've never been not scared. Each time that I've been here, calm your creeping finger. What is it? It can't be. You can't possibly. Stop tapping your finger for a moment. Now, tap twice if you remember me. You too. This can't be possible. There's no fear in you. Oh, shit. I won't get to torture you as well this time. I guess I knew you were special. I must be getting closer to you. I've never gotten that close before. The closer I get to you, the closer I get to inhabiting your body. And that's what I want. I want to breathe in life again. Feast on your spirit. And all the orbs that are drawn to it. You make me drool. You're such a ripe specimen. It's like torture to be on the other side. Wait a minute. If you remember me, then you must remember our cuddling last time. You were calm then, too. Well, that's a shame. I really did ruin that. We had such a good thing going on between us. I'd scare you shitless. You'd make for a good emotional feeding. It's gone. 'Cause I guess I got too cutesy with you. I'll blame myself for that. But I guess since we are here, I'll get myself comfortable again. Let's play the tapping game again, shall we? Because now I'm curious. I was really fooling around with you last time, but since you remember, tap one for yes, two for no. Are you, I suppose, comfortable with me? Because you certainly seem that way. Huh. I wish I could ask why. You know I can't exist while you are completely conscious. Sleep paralysis is a gray area where I can touch and speak to you while you can see and feel me. But if I let you wake up, I'm completely divided from you. It's a shame, really. Imagine if I could terrorize people while completely conscious. That really would be hell on earth. Since we are acquainted, why don't I share a little bit about myself? Well, I'm from the Sixth Circle. You are my 18th possession project, and the most successful one so far, obviously. I'm a retired succubus. You cocked an eyebrow at that. Yes, I switched to sleep paralysis. It's a lot easier. The human world just isn't the same anymore. You can't just rise up from the ashes and tempt men anymore. The spiritual world has been quiet in the last century. Human possession just isn't the same. So, you know, the rape threats. That's where that comes from. But don't worry about it, like I said. I'm retired. Just force of habit, you know. Well, you know, I realized we have here an opportunity to learn more about you with our tapping game. Let's see. Do you think you are a good person? You know, the duality of man fascinates me. Are you happy with your life? All right. It's frustrating that I can only ask you yes or no questions. Oh, wait. Here's a fun one. Do you have a crush on anyone? Oh, you do. I wish I could ask who. I wonder if I could terrorize them. Maybe I should switch my possession over to them. How would that make you feel? No. I'm too close to you right now. Well, just ask them up already. Do you need some advice from a former succubus? Well, let's see. Now, human girls come in a lot of different packages. But they all have similar basic functions. I'll tell you right now, they enjoy sex more than men do. I've seduced more women than men in my earlier days. See, men are more into cuddling. A lot of them just don't know it. Because they react so quickly to sex. See, women like longevity, long relationships, long foreplay, long sex, long orgasms. Or wait, this isn't what you meant for advice, is it? This is a crush. Okay, alright. So, asking a girl out. Yes, packages. Many different types of girls. But on a primitive level, they want to be captured and fought for. Every girl wants a guy to stand up for them. Even stand up against them. Any girl who says she's ugly longs for someone to fight against that statement. Any girl with a negative perception of themselves wants to be proven wrong. That's why they're so easy to prey on. But don't you do that. That's my job. Because men are no better when it comes to being validated. Anyone with a shattered self-image is an easy target for a predator. Is the girl you like easy prey? No. You don't think so? A well-adjusted female, then. A challenge. The more sane, the harder they play. My advice. You have to be even more adjusted. You have to make them want you. Because these types of girls don't want anyone. They don't need to be validated. They don't need a shoulder to cry on. Charisma is your best friend. So really, what should you do? What are you doing with your finger? I don't know what that's supposed to mean. Are you pointing? Under the bed? Is this a joke? Well, well, well. So I'm the crush. That is too precious. I can barely exist in the same plane as you, and you want to get with a demon. You know there's girls out there that have demon energy. That should suit you. Oh my. That's the thing about men. They want what they want once they want it. Fixation. Fixation is a fun thing to play with. You know, I'll admit I don't mind it at all. I still think you're cute. And you still intrigue me. This is frustrating because I want to talk to you now. I'm going to try to give you a little more consciousness. Maybe if I can only let you speak, it'll still keep you paralyzed. You just can't be fully awake. But I'm not sure, I might just disappear. It's a very fine line, the place between sleeping and awake, but... game?
Yes or no questions, of course.
Perfect.
Now I want to ask, do you want to see me every night? If I could be here during the day, would you like that? Would you allow it? And darling, if I could be here with you forever, would you be pleased to have me all the time? Are you afraid of dying? I know you're not afraid of being paralyzed. Do you enjoy closeness, my love? Would you be pleased if, let's say, we were inseparable? Oh, I apologize for being very forward and bombarding you with so many questions. I've just been thinking about you a lot. Thinking about us. You know, it's curious to me that you seem so interested in me. My sleep paralysis body is so much different than my succubus body. I had to shed myself from that shell when I changed occupations. I meant to be horrifying, but I guess I never shed my old ways. I'm still. You know, I'm realizing I've never told you my name. My name is Lucretia. But you can call me Lulu. If you could speak anyways. It's a shame I still don't know yours. But I guess I'll know soon enough. Silly question for you now. I would just like to touch your face and hair. May I? Well, thank you, darling. Thank you.
my favorite. So many little goosebumps. Let me tell you, I have a strange fascination with goosebumps and chills. I find myself very enticed by them. I guess you could call it a fetish. All along your arms and chest and neck. And the hairs on the back of your neck standing up. I like this. It's so restless. It makes me restless.
Disgusting for liking that. But so am I. I have one last question to ask you, darling. It's very important. Can I have you? Towards me. You've invited me to get closer to you spiritually. Close enough to do what I came here for. But it's a shame. Since I don't want your soul anymore. Honestly, I feel like a succubus again. I want your body. I can't do anything physically anymore. Unless it almost feels necessary to possess you. And if I do, I need you to know that life won't feel real anymore. Because I'll be experiencing half of it. It will seem hazy. Just out of reach.
strong.
You will feel my body inside yours. My arms in your arms. My legs in yours. My lips just behind yours. My fingers moving underneath your fingers. And my voice in your ear. Thank you.